What do you do when your music goals just aren't inspiring you? When you look at that to-do list and you get this heavy feeling, or you have a knot in the pit of your stomach, or maybe you just want to run away. You might start to think that maybe I really don't want this music career as much as I thought I did, because if I did, I'd be so excited to tackle my goals. I would jump out of bed every day ecstatic to work on music. Is this just a slump, or is there something else going on? If you're feeling this way, you're definitely not alone. I want you to know that this is very common and that all of us go through periods like this. When you have lofty goals, when you have goals that are really important and integral to following your calling and your life's purpose, you are going to have these periods of feeling disconnected with those goals. Maybe because you're just tired of the grind a little, or because you've got all these shiny objects around you that you think maybe I should be focusing on this instead. It's totally normal when you have a very big goal to want to run away from it, especially if you're getting close to that breakout point, to that point where you're about to do something that's way out of your comfort zone and it's gonna take you to the next level, but it feels a little or even a lot uncomfortable. And sometimes it's just the grind of consistency. If we really want to accomplish something, we have to work super hard to stay consistent at it. Remember when you first started learning how to play an instrument or to sing properly or write songs? You had to do a lot of work in that area, and some of it wasn't fun, and a lot of it took time when you felt like you were kind of spinning your wheels. So know that that is always part of the game, and that there are always ups and downs, and you will feel these super high highs and sometimes these super low lows, and that is just part of the journey. I remember when I was in college and I was performing with the school's ensemble, and we used to go out on weekends and perform all over Southern California, sometimes even Northern California. And for me, academics were very important. I was getting a double major, and so I had a lot of work to do. And I could have just said, you know, I'm gonna toss these academic goals aside and I'm gonna focus on music because that's what's taking a lot of time for me, but I didn't. I figured out how to do them both at the same time, even though it was hard. I remember times where I was doing homework in the van late at night with a flashlight on the way home from a gig, or I had to go find a quiet place in between gigs, or when we were doing a sound check for somebody besides me and just get some reading done because I had very limited time. So just know that if that's the kind of thing you're going through right now, that is totally normal. But if you feel like it's something else, if you feel like you've been super consistent and you've been very steadfast and you've felt good about it for a long time, but now there's just something going on, I've got an idea of maybe what it might be. When I'm feeling really disconnected from my goals, really out of alignment, the reason is usually because I am using the wrong measure of success. Now, don't get me wrong, I do think it's important to measure whether our goals are successful, and we need to have a metric for that. But a lot of times we're using the wrong metrics. We are using vanity metrics. And if you're wondering what vanity metrics are, they are things like, how many Facebook likes do you have? How many Instagram followers? How many Twitter followers? How many email subscribers do you have? How many people are showing up at your shows? Now, I'm not saying those aren't important metrics. They absolutely are. But when it comes down to it, when you're feeling stuck and unmotivated, those are just numbers. They aren't something that are gonna fuel you forward. What will give you the motivation you need to keep going? What should you be using as a metric to measure your goal? I say the best metric, especially when you're feeling a little bit in a slump or not excited, is engagement of your fans. The times when people come up to you after shows and want to talk to you and tell you how much that song that you did or that story that you told really touched them and how it reminded them of a time in their life. when you get people sending you direct messages on Instagram telling you how much they love your new single and how they shared it with a friend, those times when people come up to the merch table and they want to buy not just one CD, but two, because they want to take one home for themselves to remember the fantastic experience they had, but they also want to take one home for their friend because their friend wasn't able to make it and they wanted their friend to be able to have even a bit of the experience that they did at your show. And then those emails that you get. And I got a few of these recently that got me thinking about what really fuels me toward my goals. These emails say something like, what you said on that video or what you said in your song was exactly what I needed to hear today. Those are the emails that you need to save. You need to create a special folder for that. So when you're feeling like maybe you want to give up, maybe you weren't really as serious about your music career as you thought because it feels hard and it feels like maybe you're just not that excited about it, that's when you open up those emails and you remember the feeling that you had when you first read them and know what you are doing is having an impact on people. We are not just creating music for the sake of creating music. We are making a better world because of our music and because of our message. Don't ever forget that and let that light a fire under you to achieve your music career goals. Now, if you're feeling like you're not quite getting the kind of engagement that I was just talking about, then I want to invite you to come to my free masterclass at musiciansprofitpath.com, where I will teach you how to attract your 1,000 true fans without wasting valuable time and money on the wrong marketing techniques. So go over to musiciansprofitpath.com and register for free now.